Day 5 of Stay In and Make Do. Today, fairy lights. I love fairy lights. Trouble is, so do my cats.
Magnus, stop it. Maisie, no.
My cats seem to think that fairy lights are delicious glowing treats, so any sets that I have to be safely out of reach. But I don't want trailing wires, which means that battery-powered fairy lights are the way to go. That introduces a new problem, because battery-powered fairy lights in hard-to-reach places are difficult to switch on. So, watch this. And again. Problem solved. Okay. Not actually problem solved, because eventually this microbit is going to run out of battery. But take this project as inspiration to make a similar version with different electronic components if you're that way inclined, or just something to play with. Also, big disclaimer, only do this with battery powered fairy lights. Don't be doing this with the mains powered kind. I know isolation can get a bit boring and a bit of reckless endangerment can make things a bit more exciting, but trust me, electrocution is worse, so don't. Now let's get on with it. So what are you going to need for this project? Obviously a set of battery powered fairy lights, 2 microbits and battery packs, and a transistor or a relay if you have a suitable one. I'm using this transistor because I have literally 1,000 of them. It was cheaper to buy in bulk than to try and source 1 or 2 of them. And the last thing you're going to need is some wires and a way of sticking them together. So solder, conductive paint, crocodile clips, or a breadboard. Optional. If you don't have a set of battery-powered fairy lights, but you do have some LEDs knocking around, you can make a little set like this, and I will show you how to do it at the end. Our 2 microbits are going to be the transmitter and the receiver. We're going to start with the code for the transmitter, because it's super simple and there's no wiring. As usual, to make sure our microbits can talk to each other, add radio set group here. Now I'm going to make this microbit send a 1 to turn the lights on and a 0 to turn the lights off. The way I set mine up, I've used this on shake block and snapped in a radio send number to turn on the lights with a little pizzazz by shaking the microbit. But you can choose another input if you like. It could be a different gesture, a button press, or even the ambient light level. Similarly, I used this on button A pressed with radio send number 0 to turn the lights off when I press a button on my microbit. Not just any button though, specifically button A, which is the one on the left. That's the transmitter done. Time to move on to the receiver. Here's a cool trick that a Twitter friend of mine told me. If you go to makecode.com/multi-editor, you can have 2 windows of the MakeCode editor open in 1 tab. It's really handy for radio projects when you have 2 different codes that need to speak to each other. I'm not going to use it right now because we've already done our transmitter and we want to focus on our receiver, but try it out at home. Now, about that transistor I said we were going to use. Transistors are little packages of crazy physics. The science is super interesting, but we don't need to know all of that to use the transistor like we're about to, as an electronic switch. The quick and dirty version is, when voltage or a signal is applied to this middle leg, it allows electricity to flow between whatever is connected to this outside leg here, and whatever is connected to this outside leg here. When there's no voltage applied, electricity can't flow between the 2 outer legs. Our battery-powered fairy lights have a complete circuit at the moment. We're going to make a break in that circuit and put the transistor in the gap. Then we're going to use the microbit to apply voltage or not to that middle leg. And when we apply voltage, the transistor is going to let electricity flow between the two outer legs and complete the fairy light circuit, switching them on. And when we don't apply voltage to that middle leg, the circuit will stay broken and the lights will be off. The slightly complicated bit is that we need to make a break in the circuit in the right place and also put the transistor in the gap the right way round. So, take your fairy lights and find the two wires that go to the batteries. Figure out which one goes to the negative or minus terminal of the battery and cut that one specifically. Then, strip back a little bit of the insulation on both sides of that wire so that some of the metal is exposed. Take your transistor and look at it with the flat side facing towards you. Now, the left leg is going to connect to the bare wire end closest to the battery, and the right leg is going to connect to the bare wire closest to the rest of the lights. I'm using this tiny breadboard to make my connections, but you can use something else, like conductive paint. Or if you're very dexterous, you might even be able to get away with twisting the bare wire ends around the legs of the transistor. However you've decided to do it, make the connection from the transistor's middle leg to microbit's pin 0. And then the final tricky little step is to connect the transistor's left leg to microbit's ground so that it's also connected to the negative terminal of the battery. This is so that both parts of the circuit agree on what ground is. Don't worry if you find this complicated. I was trying to use a set of USB fairy lights originally and misidentified which was the negative wire. I managed to fry several transistors before I figured it out. In my defense, I also had a defective crocodile clip. Now to write the super simple code for this microbit. As always, start by setting your radio group to the same as the previous code. Then grab this on radio received number block. Remember, we're sending a 1 to turn the lights on and a 0 to turn the lights off, so we want to check which number we've received. For that, we can use an if-else block. Grab this comparison block from logic, and we're going to make it say if received number is a 1. In that case, we want to switch the lights on. And for that, we're going to use something new and exciting. Under Advanced, go into Pins and grab this digital write pin block and put it in here. We want digital write pin pin 0 to 1, because computers do that whole binary thing where 1 is on and 0 is off. So this line basically means turn pin P0 on. Apply voltage. Let there be light. Then, in this else part, which happens when the other microbit sends us a 0, we want the opposite. Digital write pin P0 to 0. Off. Kill the lights. And there you have it. Remote-controlled fairy lights. If you haven't got any fairy lights or batteries lying around, but you do have LEDs, you can make your own little fairy light strip like I have. I've wired 5 standard red LEDs in parallel with a 10 or 12 ohm resistor. The reason being, I'm going to make things even easier for myself. I'm not going to use a battery pack at all. I'm going to power this strip from the microbit's 3 volt output. And that's the reason that I've used 5 LEDs. That many wired in parallel with this small resistor is probably, by my calculations, the maximum that I can do without exceeding the maximum current that the microbit likes to put out. We don't want to fry our microcontroller when we have weeks of isolation and electronics ahead of us. To make them look really good, connect them with long wires rather than the short ones I've got on this breadboard, and use some ping pong balls as diffusers. Here's a challenge for you. See if you can rewrite the code so that each time you shake the transmitter, it changes from sending a 1 to a 0 and back again, so that you only have to make one gesture. Leave your solution in the comments so that other people can see it. And remember, stay in, make do, and keep it light. If you haven't got any brains, like me.